To be resuming work on one of the battle tracks, not the one I worked on, not the Outnumbered remix, but the one I was working on before that. And then, depending on how far we get, I'll probably switch gears and load up Outnumbered and finish off the stream working on that. So, a two for one today. Looks like it just finished loading, so I'm gonna play through it. We're gonna give it a listen, and then we're gonna go from there. What I need to do here is set up the very end of the piece. I haven't actually done that yet, so it'll set itself up to loop. And then it's just gonna be a lot of tweaking, fine-tuning, balance changes and stuff. It's coming along, but there are still some things that need to be done, especially with the guitar and whatnot. I might need to go in and disable some of my plugins. We'll see how the performance is. I know this is pretty intensive on my computer, so might have to stop midway and disable some things so this runs smoother. But hopefully things go okay. So it looks like I will need to make some adjustments. So hold on one second, I'll play it through it again, hopefully without any of those pops and glitches. So what I'm doing is just disabling a lot of the reverb that I use. Each instrument section has its own reverb to try and kind of position them correctly on a virtual stage, like a sound stage. That's, each one takes up some, processing power, and when you've got a dozen loaded, plus EQ effects and things, it really does take a toll. What I'm gonna do So what I'm going to do is load up some really, really efficient reverb. It's reverb I haven't used in a long time. Yeah, it's just a Cubase default. And that should help.
Thank you.
So what I'm doing right now is going in and I'm trying to give it a little more kind of definition in the low end. So I added some short strings, some cellos and basses to help kind of emphasize that that rhythm. And now I'm going to go in and see if I can add in one more synth to just give it a little more energy and push, because it really loses a lot of energy in this section, which is just not a bad thing, but it loses a little bit too much. we're going to bring up the choirs to kind of fill that all out. A little more body. Okay, so I'm going to leave that alone right now and go in and now set up the loop. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually take take sections from the very beginning, and I'm going to put that at the end, and that's going to it's going to slowly fade in and kind of set up the beginning of the track. So I think it's going to work pretty well. I just have to wait for the autosave and go ahead and do that. And I still haven't even gone in and taken out a lot of that temp piano, which is something I might do off screen, because that's going to be some work. I've relied a little bit too much on that, and I do want a piano part, because all the Sunny Music is that piano. And so I'm going to have to go in and really overhaul that, but I'll do that off screen, because that's not going to be fun and probably not at all enjoyable to watch.
Thank you. Thank you.
So at this part, I'm trying to, with the horns and with the choirs, I'm trying to get this sense of, you know, uplift. And so what I'm going to try to do now is swap out some of the choirs or fortify the choirs with a more aggressive sounding choir, something more epic. And that should help this kind of swell into the setup for the loop. So I like the idea of having a guitar here, and I like the aesthetics of these guitar sounds, but this one right here is really, really tinny sounding, really trebly. And there's not a whole lot I'm going to be able to do about that, so I might have to swap that out. But I'm going to play with some filters and see if I can just tone it down a little bit. Okay, so I'm gonna mix this down, and then maybe at the end of the stream we'll play it through. I'm gonna enable all of the good reverb and the equalizer and all of that. So hopefully the mix down sounds better than it does in its current form. So this mix down is going to take a few minutes, so I have to be a little patient. And so when I'm done doing this, I'm going to load up Outnumbered for that remix, and then I'm going to continue where I picked up on that,
we'll be right back.
So now that this is loaded, I've got to toggle on some of the reverb. I don't know why I got turned off, but it's really dry. So give me a second here. Okay, there we go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to separate this new section that I wrote last time, and I'm going to actually create a lead into that. That's quite an abrupt change, where the playback cursor is here. I'll play that again. That's a pretty abrupt change, so I'm going to have it cut and drop down and then lead into that new section. And I think that's going to work quite a bit better. Can be a little tricky to separate parts out, you know, when you've got 30 or 40 different instruments doing different things and you want to add in an extra few seconds or an extra, you know, few measures. It can be difficult to split things up in a sequencer. cutting and pasting is not quite as simple as it is in, you know, text editors or things like that. You really have to go in and make sure you're not moving the wrong things, and things oftentimes end up moving when you don't want them to. So it's not the most enjoyable part of the process, but I think I got it here. Just broke my own rule there and did percussion first, but I pretty much know what needs to be done. So, whatever. Thank you. I'm torn with the xylophone because I it's such a fantastic instrument, but it does have kind of a comical feel. Like that. And so I might take it out, but it really adds nice definition and energy. So I'm gonna leave it in for now as I'm orchestrating, and then we'll see where we are.
Thank you.
So what I'm doing here is I want it to drop way down for that little four bar intro to the next section. And so I'm just trying to find ways to shave off some of the dynamics, some of the volume. It'll create more contrast. It's a nice breather in the track. And it really, you know, in music, as I've said before, we create drama through contrast, just like in movies and just like in every other art. Contrast is really key to keeping the listener engaged, because loud is not loud if that's all there is. Loud just is normal. And so I want to drop this down, and that's going to really set us up for a nice build-up over the next section. One great way and a timeless way of creating a feeling of tension is to have your violins play really, really, really quietly and really, really high, just these sustained notes. It's something that's used in horror. It's used in all sorts of genres. And it's one of those felt, not quite heard things. I mean, if you listen for it, you can hear it, but it really creates this feeling that you're on edge. I'll play it through now. It's a very small change, but it's makes a big difference. I'm going to play through the original track from Sunny 2 now, just to kind of keep my reference. So I think at the very end of this track, I'm going to use the exact same ending that I had in the original. So kind of it sandwiched in between the beginning and the end of the original, I've got all this new material. But that was a pretty good loop. It set itself up well, so I don't see any reason to really mess with it. So I'm gonna rewrite that, probably not today, but I'm gonna rewrite that at the very end, and that should set up the loop really nicely.
Oh!
All right, yeah, so all the new stuff still needs a lot of work and orchestration and things, but this should make for a really solid loop. And I'm not sure. Looks like it comes in about a minute and a half, so that's good. That's what I've been shooting for most of these tracks, and it's been more or less on point. So before I stop the stream today, because I think I've hit a good stopping point for this track, I'm going to play what I was working on earlier. Hopefully glitch free. So let me load that in. I tried to set up that loop. Let me do it one more time, see if I can get this looped properly. Oh, I guess in my render, I didn't actually render it to loop properly, so I can't do that. But it's coming along. I'm really happy with how this track is turning out. Again, you know, it still needs some work, and when I get to the point where I render all of my stems and the track separately and put on the effects and the reverb, everything's going to sound kind of more homogeneous. But it's I think it strikes the right balance between all that we're going for, the the darker mood, the sense of despair and anguish kind of towards the end, but also that rising up and getting your second wind, so to speak. So I'm pretty happy with this. I'm gonna have to send this to Crane and get his feedback. I hope he doesn't hate it. That would be not great. So thanks for tuning in as usual. Leave your comments if you have any. And I don't know when my next stream will be. It might be on Saturday. That's when I've been usually using it, but I might take Saturday off and maybe do it on Sunday, or maybe wait till next Tuesday. So I'll update the live stream channel, I guess, the live stream page, to indicate when the next stream is. And I hope to see you there. Thanks for tuning in.